everybody, it's your girl Brooklyn with Heart's Heart with Brooklyn, and today we are making a change. We are here in Atlanta at the protest because we are here to make a change. Black lives matter, and we have to make sure we make it known, okay? So please make sure you follow my journey down here at the protest.
As many of you all know, Atlanta is known for its culture. From the food to the music, Atlanta has always kept Black culture alive and has cherished it ever since. It is home to many diverse groups of people, but ultimately to those of color. Being that Atlanta is a predominantly Black city, many people have been outraged about the current and ongoing way Black people are treated not only in this country, but all over the world. Being that this is my home, I decided to not only march for a change, but also find out why others are taking a stand as well.
So what does protesting mean to you, and why exactly are you out here today?
I think protesting is what we do in America when we see things that aren't right. And I'm just out here today because we need to make it right. We need to show that everybody needs civil rights and human rights, and we got to do it now or never. That's why.
So I see that you guys are out here with the protesters and encouraging people to vote. So how important is it for these people to vote right now?
I think it's super important, one, because of who the president is right now and how he's basically militarizing the police force and the military against peaceful protesters, and other than everything else he's done, you know, putting immigrant youth in cages and things like that. So I think that's important, but also just your local elections. That has a lot to do with what police do, like voting for your sheriffs, your mayor. Your mayor's in control of local police forces, so that's super important.
Thank you. And what about you?
So we believe in empowering people in various ways. We believe in protesting. We believe in voting. We believe in making our voices heard through legislation, through challenging qualified immunity for police, against police. I've been at this for a long time. We actually had a whole lot more people out here. I'm one of the older folks. This is my mentee. Law is my background. So we have the lawyers addressing things in the court system, and we are doing things on many digital platforms across the nation. And I've been at this for a long time, like I said, whether it's marching or whatever it takes. So we are going to address this one step at a time and on various levels, no matter what it takes. And we're going to work with people like yourselves on these platforms. We're happy for what you're doing to get the word out, to get the vote out, and to let people know that the revolution is being televised. And we thank you for what you do, and it will not stop until we succeed. It's a new day, it's a new time, and we're here in it to win it.
Two groups, with Millennial Civil Rights and the Unity of Us, and both of these groups definitely focus on promoting just a peaceful protest among all of us and the minorities and millennials of the group. So the Unity of Us group, what we do is we hand out flowers to everyone here to kind of shine light and kind of like make it a more positive, peaceful march, so to speak, contrary to what the news show with all the violence going on. And Millennial Civil Rights is a group hosted by owned by my friend Teo Swin. And what they do is kind of promote people to vote. They encourage millennials to go on and vote and to be part of the movement, to use the hashtag WeSaveUs, which means that you took the pledge to, you know, practice social distancing, to vote, and to just be a part of the community and try to, you know, inspire other people as much as you can. So that is Millennial Civil Rights, hashtag WeSaveUs, which is taking the pledge, social distancing, marching together in peace, and the Unity of Us is hosted by a bunch of girls, you know, Latinas, Morenas, Whites, all of us, and we're just handing out flowers and trying to make sure that we're all happy and just colorful as best as we can be. So that's the way it's also safe for children to join us and everything, so.
Wow, that's really amazing, especially considering that the media right now is portraying protesters in such a terrible light. So the fact that you're out here handing out flowers, being positive protesters, unlike how the media is showing us right now, is really inspirational. I really appreciate everything that you're doing, because right now, this is how we make a change.
I'm here to support my girlfriend, who's mixed, and that this movement means a lot to her, so I want to support her. I think that for-profit prisons are bad. I hadn't realized for-profit prisons were even a problem until recently, and I watched a documentary with my girlfriend called 13th, and it kind of opened up my eyes to that. I think that's definitely something that needs to be changed. For-profit prisons are obviously bad, so since 2000, something like 47% in terms of prisoners in private prisons. So since 2000, private prisons have increased by 47% for individual prisoners. So public prisons obviously aren't for profit, but private prisons are. So it's kind of a big deal. But yeah.
Thank you so much for being out here, for your support. And I know your girlfriend definitely appreciates you being out here for you.
Many people believe this movement is solely about the unlawful death of George Floyd, when it's actually bigger than that. It's for Breonna Taylor, Tayvon Martin, Ahmaud Arbery, and all the lives lost solely due to the color of their skin. It's for the racism we endure on the daily and the injustices we continue to fight. Your skin tone should not be a death sentence. You shouldn't have to fear for your life while jogging, driving, or simply being in your own home. Parents should not have to bury their children simply for existing. The purpose of law enforcement is to keep us safe, yet some use their power for evil. 400 years has been enough, and now it's time for real change.
Protested because we're sick of this shit. We are tired. We're tired of police getting away with killing unarmed black people, and not just police, but white people in general. And we're tired of systematic racism and how it goes to the education system, how it goes to voting, how it goes to the legal system and everything. And we want equality in this country. And we're here to make a stance, because today will be the change that you're going to see for the rest of the country. Sounds good. Why are you here protesting today?
I'm speaking for the people that are afraid to speak up. I'm out here for a cause. I want change.
I'm a college student. I don't know much about politics or nothing like that, but I know that this works. This is what I can do. So this is why I'm out here.
Well, you know, this has been going on so long, and so many black men have lost their lives, and it just felt good being down here. I want to do something to try to make a change. This morning when I woke up, you know, I wasn't too sure if I was going to come, but I saw my nephew, Lil Jordan, and I saw him hold his Black Lives Matter sign, and it gave me the energy that I needed to come down here and to make a change. And that had given me the spark that I need to change things in any way I can. So if any part I can play in making the world a better place as far as where we all can get along and where we don't have so much discrimination against people because of their color, I plan on being part of that from this day on. And even though that's how I've always lived, but now I think it's even more important now.
Today, guys, with Heart to Heart with Brooklyn. Please make sure you watch, subscribe, and tell all your friends, and also spread the word. Sign petitions, do your part, because we are here to make a change, and you need to be part of the movement. So yes, definitely follow me, and I will see you guys later. Peace out, guys.